In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus Christ from the dead, be with all of you. In the waters of baptism, Jeanne died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Jeanne, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. My friends, please be seated. We take this opportunity this morning to hear God's comforting and consoling word, which he speaks to us through his Holy Scripture. And to help us hear God's word for us in our first reading, I invite Renee to come forward.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Happy is the one who finds wisdom, the one who gains understanding. For her profit is better than profit in silver, and better than gold is her revenue. She is more precious than corals, and none of your possessions can compare with her. Long life is in her right hand, in her left are riches and honor. Her ways are pleasant ways, and all her paths are peace. She is the tree of life for those who grasp her, and he is happy who holds her fast. The Lord by wisdom founded the earth, established the heavens by understanding. By his knowledge the depths break open and clouds drop down dew. Let not these slip out of your sight. Keep advice and counsel in view. So will they be life to your soul and an adornment for your neck. Then may securely go your way. Your foot will never stumble. When you lie down, you need not be afraid. When you rest, your sleep will be sweet. Honor is the possession of wise men, but fools inherit shame. The word of the Lord.
my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near as for waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit.
And to help us hear God's word for us in our second reading, I invite Michael to come forward.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if you believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
My friends, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How could we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. My dear friends, as we gather together with our sister Jeanne this morning around this altar, a place that she knew well, and a place that every time she visited would hear her God speak to her. And I today offer my prayer for each one of you, her loved ones, her family, and her friends who gather this morning, that you may hear those same words that she would hear. It's the same message God wants to whisper to each of our hearts every time we have the courage to draw near to his altar. He wishes to speak to us words that are transforming. Words that, when we use them as human beings, even with our own brokenness, can change lives when we use them with each other. Three simple words, but yet are so powerful. I love you. I love you. Those words, when we use them with each other, can change a rainy, cloudy, stormy day into a bright, sunshiny day for each one of us. And so imagine what it is then to hear God, who is all good and loving, speak them to us. They're empowering. Jeanne was empowered by those words. The way she loved you, her family and her friends, the moments that she shared with each one of you were an extension of those three words that she got the courage to share that kind of love and hope and joy with you. And so today as we gather around this altar, even in the midst of our tears, I hope and pray that in this liturgy you get to hear God speak that to you. You know, the beautiful book of Revelation, John tells us in Revelation 21 that in the end, God will wipe out of our eyes all our tears. He doesn't say he's just going to wipe our eyes from tears. No, John tells us God's going to wipe them out of our eyes. Why? Well, Jeanne knows it well today. When we are in heaven, gathered together with all our brothers and sisters, with our God, we'll have no more need for tears. There'll be no more crying and weeping and mourning. And that's why even in the midst of our grief, we come here today and we give thanks to God. He has wiped out of Jeanne's eyes all tears and has filled her now with all that she needs of love, peace, and joy. And we're thankful for that today. We're thankful for God, as Jesus told his disciples before that Last Supper, I'm going to build a place for you, and I'm going to go away and I'm going to come back again so that I can take you to myself. That's what our Lord has done for our sister. And that's what we come here to this altar today to say thank you, God, for. Thank you. Because she deserves that. By the way, she shared and built as best she could God's peace and love and hope through her actions and her words here on earth. Not afraid to be a voice of God, to be his hands, to be his heart to others. And so, my friends, today let's continue her legacy of love. Let's be that voice of God to others. May no one around us ever wonder, does God talk anymore in 2024? May they never wonder that, because we used our words and they heard God. May no one ever wonder, does God even care? Does he even love anymore? May no one in our circle of friends and family ever wonder that. They'll know God cares and loves because of the way we use our heart. God forbid anyone around us ever wonder, I can't feel God anymore. Does God even work? They'll never wonder because they will have felt God through our hands and the way we act in our world. If we are willing to have that kind of courage to be God's words, his heart, his hands for everyone around us, we'll continue the legacy left for us by Jeanne. And we'll be assured that together again, on that great 18th hole in heaven, we'll join with her once again. God bless you. My friends, let's stand and bring our prayers, our petitions to our Heavenly Father. And to help lead us in our prayers, I invite Stephanie to come forward.
In baptism, Jeanne received the light of the Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our sister Jeanne was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our family have gone before us and await the kingdom. We remember in a special way Dennis Pisani, Nicholas and Pauline Sosi, and Paul Sosi. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Jeanne seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Jeanne. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear our prayers we place before you in confidence that you will answer them. We ask them through Christ our Lord. Amen. My friends, please be seated. As we prepare the altar for the celebration of our Eucharist, I invite Tracy, Julianne, Elizabeth, and Nicole to present our gifts.
Gentlewoman, quiet night, morning star. So strong and bright. gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Let's stand. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Jeanne, we beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him now a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with all the choirs of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts,
are able to, please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also your servant, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's stand. And at the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that through the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and
I go.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Jeanne may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. Amen. Friends, please be seated. I'd like to invite Dennis to come forward now and share with us some words of remembrance.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you all for coming today. This really does mean a lot to my whole family that you're all here. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Dennis Pisani. I am Chris's oldest son, Jeannie's third oldest grandchild, and potentially her favorite grandchild. I'm just kidding, guys, just kidding. I was named after Jeannie's late husband, Dennis, so maybe it's kind of fitting that I'm the one speaking today. Unfortunately, last week, we had to say goodbye to my Grammy. All 10 of us grandkids were so lucky to have her in our lives as long as we did. Living to see numerous graduations, 2 grandkids get married, and even the birth of her great-grandchild, we all thought she was going to live forever. She was such an integral part of all of our lives, helping raise us to be the great people that we are today. She was a long life Franklin resident, raising her 3 kids, Stephen, Chris, and Amy. She was a devoted mom, aunt, grandmother, and friend to many. She had a huge impact on the town of Franklin through coaching tennis, softball, and working at the Franklin polls every election. Every Christmas, she would make a huge batch of cookies for the whole family, even if some of them were a little dry, but they were all still amazing. When she babysat us when we were little, we would have the best time. Whenever I slept over, she would always put on this movie, Jumanji, and she knew it scared the crap out of me, but she would play it anyways just to get a reaction out of me. And if you don't know Jumanji, it's not a scary movie at all. Now, there are 3 things that I wanted to, about my Grammy that I wanted to bring up today. The first thing that made her so great was that she always spoke her mind. If you asked her what her opinion was on something, she would tell you how she really feels. She wouldn't tell you what you want to hear. Even if she made inappropriate comments in public, we still loved her for it. The second thing about her was that she was very thoughtful. I can speak for all of us grandkids that she would always send us a text when she was thinking of us, or when she came across an old picture from when we were babies. And then she would always leave it with her signature, XOXO. That was the best part. This one time, she did text me. She said, "Denny, I was watching a movie, and your twin was in it. And not my twin sister, Stephanie. She was talking about Zac Efron." So I kind of was like, "Grammy, you're absolutely right. I do look like Zac Efron. Yes, I do look like the Hollywood heartthrob." So maybe there was a reason she needed to wear those glasses, I don't know. The last thing about my Grammy was that she lived her life with no regrets. She always did it with a smile. She was such an active and vibrant person. She skied, she golfed, and she even had time to make it to all of our sporting events growing up. I am bummed I never got the chance to golf with her, but I know she would have kicked my butt if we did. To be honest, that wouldn't have mattered to her, though. She would have been ecstatic just to get the chance to do something with any of her grandkids. She had this aura about her that made us all smile and laugh, and she always made you feel safe and loved. Her laugh was very infectious, as we all know, made you all feel better. I think all of us here can take that from her. She would want us to keep living our best lives, celebrating the time we had with her and not dwelling on the fact that she's gone. She made a positive impact on everyone here today. Maybe now that she's watching over me, I'll finally break 90 on the golf course. I'm happy she gets to finally reunite with our grandpa. You two probably have a lot of catching up to do up there. So, Grammy, I love you. We all love you. And your memory is going to live on with all of us.
Let's stand. My friends, trusting in God, we have prayed together for our sister, and now we come to our last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Jeanne again and enjoy her friendship. And although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. So let's console one another now with the assurances of faith. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us now and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith. Till we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
To God in heaven.
find such harmony. Born of holy, known together, of Christ's love and.